Family Feud. What is the top answer to this question? If money isn't everything, name something that is. If you said the number one answer is love, you hit the bullseye on the new Family Feud. Introducing the Shannon family, ready for action. Playing against the Lee family. On your mark, let's start the new Family Feud. Here's the star of Family Feud, Ray Cohn.
Thank you so very much. Hello to the Shannon family once more. Welcome to the Lee family.
Welcome to you.
And welcome to the new Family Feud. We're starting a brand new season on the Family Feud, and to help us celebrate, we're introducing an exciting new game called Bullseye. In the Bullseye game, one of our two families can take home a jackpot that they will build up that could be $20,000. They'll determine that amount themselves. Let's waste no time. Meet our returning champions, the Shannon family.
Hey, glad to be back.
Nice to have you back. You have $13,000. This is your third time on the show. Tell everybody where you're from and quickly who you brought.
We're from Southern California. I brought my husband, Jim.
Yes.
My sister, Kathy. Mm-hmm. My brother, John. And my baby brother, Rob.
Nice to see you again. Let's see how you like your opponent, the lovely Lee family. Essa?
Hi.
Where are you from? New York City. Southern California against the East Coast. Who did you bring with you?
I brought with me my sister, Lisa.
Yes.
My sister-in-law, Grace.
Hi.
My cousin, Estella.
Yes.
And my cousin, Ina.
This is the Battle of the Coast. How would you like to take home $20,000? You might do that if you build that bank. So let's start with our big new money bullseye game. Head to the family. Please join us. Each member of each family will get a chance to play the bullseye round to determine how large the bank will be. But in fairness, we like to start by giving $5,000 to the Lee Family Bank, $5,000 to the Shannon Family Bank. And to get at the $20,000 is up to you. In the bullseye game, I'm going to ask you a question that we ask 100 people. The number one answer is the bullseye. In the first question, it is worth $1,000. Name an animal that has horns.
Joan?
Rhinoceros.
Is rhinoceros the bullseye? No. Essa, stay here. An animal that has horns.
A deer.
Is deer the bullseye? No. The bullseye answer for $1,000 was? Cattle. We'll take two more players. See if we can raise that $5,000 bank. $2,000 will go to one of these families' banks if they can give me the bullseye answer to this. Name something that once you learn how to do it, you never forget. Lisa.
Ride a bike.
Is ride a bike the bullseye? Bullseye! $7,000. The lead bank grows too. We now have a $3,000 question. We ask 100 people this, but only one answer is the bullseye. Name something that makes a man look distinguished.
Kathy.
Tuxedo.
For $3,000, is tuxedo the bullseye? Grace, do you know something makes a man look...
Gray hair.
Is gray hair the bullseye? Bullseye! $3,000 more. $10,000 currently sitting in the Lee Bank. John, you could pick up $4,000 for your bank if you give me the bullseye answer to this. Name an occupation in which you can, in which you're convinced that many people take bribes. We go to John.
Police officer.
Is police officer the bullseye? No. Now, Estella, an occupation in which you're convinced that people take bribes. $4,000?
A lawyer.
Is lawyer the bullseye? No. The bullseye, occupation that takes bribes? Show it to us. Politician. Let's try to put $5,000 more in someone's bank. One bullseye answer, $5,000. Name a little boy in a comic strip. Rob?
Sluggo.
Sluggo. Is it the bullseye? Don't say anything. Ina, for $5,000, name a little boy in a comic strip.
Little Rich.
Little Rich? Is it the Bullseye? No! $5,000 would have been given to one of the family's banks if they'd said the Bullseye. Little boy? Dennis the Menace! But we have $10,000 in the Lee Family Bank, $5,000 in the Shannon Family Bank. That's the money that they'll be playing for in Fast Money if they win the feud. When we return after these messages, don't go away, a lot of fun in store. Back and it's time to play the feud. Let's go, Asa. Joe, 13 to 300 points will play Fast Money for the bank they have built. The Lee family have $10,000 in their bank. The Shannons have $5,000. They could have built $20,000, and your family could do the same. And here's how you can get on the show to do it.
If your family would like to try out for Family Feud and you live in the Los Angeles area, call area code 213-965-9999. If you live in the New York area, call area code 212-755-3383. Back to Ray.
Thank you, Gene Wood. Call today. We'd love to have you on the Feud. Essa, your family's from?
New York.
Come from New York all the way, so God bless you there. Watching on WOR. They're watching to see if you know the number one answer to a question we ask of 100 people. The top five answers are on the board. Try to find the most popular answer to this. Name a specific kind of place where people are self-conscious about the shape their body is in. Essa.
A beach.
Show me beach. Number one, champs, think of a steal. You want to win this game to play for that $10,000.
Yeah.
Lisa. Hi. Kind of place where people are self-conscious about the shape their body is in.
A gym.
Show me a gym. 67 points in the bank, I think. Grace, you have that look kind of like, I don't know. What do you think our 100 Americans say?
A job such as modeling at work.
Maybe... At their job. One strike. Estella, a place where people are self-conscious about the shape their body is in.
A fashion show?
Maybe a fashion show?
Good answer.
You can steal the first bank, champions. Ina.
Ina.
You say Ina, I say Ina. It's Ina.
Oh, no.
It's Ina.
Ina.
Ina. Okay.
I say beauty passion.
I say beauty passion.
Yeah!
Whatever. Ina, Ina. I love you if I see a beauty pageant. Well, let me go over here to Rob.
Yes, Rube.
Kind of place where people are self-conscious about the shape their body's in.
The locker room.
Locker room.
Clothing store.
Clothing store.
A clothing store.
Clothing
pool.
Store.
Pool.
You tell Joan what you want her to
pool.
Say.
Pool's good. Pool's good.
Pool.
Pool.
I like pool.
Now you can steal the 67 points. I need an answer in 3 seconds.
Pool.
Is it?
Pool.
At the pool. The first bank goes to the champions. 87 points. Lovely Lee gals. Number four, our survey said, people are very self-conscious about. Nudist thing. Nice to know that five people that watch our show are sitting somewhere naked right now. And number five, doctor's office. This feud has only begun. Believe me, there's going to be a lot more fun to find out who will play. The $5,000 in Fast Money or 10. We'll be back in a moment to see. Right now, the Shannon family, 87 points. The Lee family, zero. Let's go with another stage song. We are going to double the point value. The Lee family have come all the way from New York, built a bank of $10,000 they'd like to take back to the Big Apple. Jim, your job is to try to stop them and play for your $5,000. Top five answers are there. Oh, this is a good question. We ask 100 people. Name someone with a reputation as a playboy. Lisa.
Hugh Hefner.
Hugh Hefner. He made the survey, but one answer, Jim. Name someone who, with a reputation as a playboy, who could be more popular. quickly. All right? Back, think of a steal. You know, Grace, now you look like you know this.
I do.
We asked men and women, someone with a reputation as a playboy.
Ted Kennedy.
There you go, Judge. Wait a minute here, let's see. Ted Kennedy. No comment, because I respect all politicians. Estella, someone with a reputation as a playboy.
Don Juan.
Don Juan. Let me see. Did Don Juan make our survey? No. 100 people is a little hope. Now, Nina.
Valentino.
Who?
Yeah!
Valentino!
Okay. Right. They're going back away. Rudolph Valentino.
Good.
Two strikes. Now, keep in mind, 100 average Americans today answered this question. Name someone with a reputation as a playboy.
Warren Beatty?
Yeah. Is it Warren Beatty? 33 people said it. Point value is doubled. What do you think, you know?
Donald Trump.
Yes, he's a playboy. He's a boy who plays like he has $1 billion. Let me see. Donald Trump.
Yes!
He made it. 13 people said Donald Trump. Boy, oh boy, I don't think I see a Republican on there. All right, Grace.
Rob Lowe.
Well, Rob Lowe. If Rob Lowe is there, you have a clean sweep, and I know Rob had some problems. Of course, it happened at the Democratic National Convention. Let us see. Rob Lowe. Three strikes. Here we go. What do you say there? Someone with a reputation as a playboy.
Jack Nicholson.
Jack Nicholson.
Mel Gibson.
Mel Gibson.
President Kennedy.
President Kennedy.
Clinton.
Who?
Clinton.
All right, you tell Joan what you want her to say. There's one answer that will get you the steal. You can go on your own.
Okay.
3 seconds.
JFK.
Going with President Kennedy. Do you steal the bank? With JFK. No. The Lee women keep their bank. Now, there were a couple of other answers. The family tried to get you to say Clinton, a Democratic nomination. And who else? Jack Nicholson, all right. Let me see, what was number four? George Hamilton. We got 148 for the Lees, 87 for the Shannons. Let's go. Either team can win. We're going to triple the point value on this question. If you take this question out, you're playing for 10 grand. You'll be playing for $5,000. Top six answers are on the board. Listen carefully before you slap the buzzer. Name something that police officers do to the people they arrest once they get them to the station. Grace?
Read them their rights.
Okay, read them their rights. Not there.
Fingerprint them.
Fingerprint them. That's number one. Think of a steal. Interesting question. We just recently surveyed. Triple the point value, John.
They take their picture.
How about it? Take their picture.
Yes. Right,
take a mugshot. Rob?
Book them.
Is it something the police officers do to the people they arrest once they get them to the station?
Book them, Dano.
Book them, Dano.
All right.
It is enough to win.
Throw them in the slammer.
Throw them in the slammer.
Good answer.
Yeah. Jim?
They take their valuables.
Take their valuables. Hope for the Lee family. Kathy.
Strip them.
They strip them. That happens after they put them in the cell. All right, John.
They let them make a phone call.
Let them make one phone call. Are you alive with it? Yes. Think of the steal. You can win the game. Rob, if you can give me number three, you're playing for $5,000. If not, they're going for the steal. 3 seconds.
Search them.
They search them for the game. Do you know number three? Something police officers do to the people they arrest once they get them to the station. Nina.
Call the lawyer.
Call the lawyer, Estella. anything?
Take off the handcuffs.
Before you answer, you may go with him or on your own. One answer will determine if you play for $10,000. What do you say?
We're going to go with remove the handcuffs.
Is it for the game? Remove the restraints. Yes! Keep their back. Chris would have gotten it. I never know what's there, but maybe they interrogate them. What was number three? Could have won you the game. Interrogate them. Let me say goodbye. Tell all the people in New York we love them. Gee, you're great. Thanks. Stay right here. I got a nice parting gift for you. Two players are needed right now for $5,000. When we return, the Shannon family will attempt to take $5,000 against that big board in the bank they built up. Don't go away. Family, they're about to play Fast Money for $5,000. Good luck. We put 15 seconds on the clock. I'm going to ask you five questions that we ask 100 people. Give me the most popular answer. Of all the photos in your home, what one person is in most of them?
Mother.
An animal you see on country roads?
Dog.
Something specific that people spill on their clothes?
Wine.
Your favorite Muppet?
Kermit.
Something that your dog does?
Bark.
Okay. Turn around. I think you were thinking. Of all the photos in your home, what person is in most of them, you said?
Mom.
Mom. Survey said? 10. An animal you see on a country road, you chose? A dog. The survey chose? 6. Something that people spill on their clothes, you liked? To spill wine. Our survey liked? 7. Maybe you made up for it with this.
Maybe
you kind of smiled. Your favorite Muppet, you said?
Kermit.
The survey said? 51!
Get up there a little bit.
Something that your dog does, you said he barks. Our survey said? Bark on 51. 125. Here comes Kathy, your sister. $5,000 await you. You are just 75 points away. We put 20 seconds on the clock. Now I'm going to ask you the same five questions that I asked your partner. Now, if you hear this sound, it means you have duplicated one of his answers, and I'll say try again.
Okay.
You ready?
I'm ready.
You're not nervous?
Oh, I'm very nervous.
Just relax.
What else is new?
Okay. We asked 100 people. Of all the photos in your home, what one person is in most of them?
Your spouse?
An animal you see on country roads?
A deer?
Something specific that people spill on their clothes?
Milk?
Your favorite Muppet?
Kermit the Frog.
Try again.
Fozzie Bear.
Something that your dog does?
Rolls over.
Oh, really? Turn around. You're 75 away. What?
It was bad.
No, we'll see if it was bad. We'll see. Of all the photos that are in your home, what one person is in most of them, you said? Your spouse. Our survey said? 11 people, and our survey said that they had pictures of your spouse in their home. Child was the number one answer. An animal you see on country roads, you said? A deer. Survey said? 18 people agreed. Rabbit was number one. Something that people spill on their clothes, you liked? Milk? Survey said? 0. Coffee was the number one answer. No, you have two answers. I know a lot of the Muppets. Your favorite Muppet was? Fozzie Bear. Survey said? 0. Kermit the Frog was number one. Something your dog does, you said? Rolls over. Well, what did the survey say? It said that bark was number one, and it said that you get $5 a point, giving you another $770. Come out here and hug him. Child may have taken him over the top. Coffee might have given him their $5,000. We're going to come right back. Don't go away. Here comes the family. They want their money. Come on up. Hi. Thanks for watching The Feud. I'm Ray Combs. We'll see you next time.
Some of our departing contestants will receive whole and or all fruit, sweetened only with fruit juice, no sugar added. Taste the fruit, not the sugar. Pass the whole and or all fruit, but please don't dare call it jelly. On the Scandinavian seas, some of the wildest storms happen below deck because of Royal Copenhagen Men's Cologne. Your choice of his or her watches from Lucien Picard's Royal Collection. Crafted for dress or sportswear, stylish two-tone bracelet and Swiss movement from Lucien Picard. Flash finish from Jonel. Dries nail polish in less than a minute as it hardens nail enamel to reduce chipping and cracking. Flash finish from Jonel. St. Ives Swiss Formula Collagen Elastin Lotion. St. Ives Swiss Formula soothes and softens dry skin instantly, naturally. St. Ives Swiss Formula. Can't get to sleep? Nitol or Maximum Strength Nitol will safely help you fall asleep fast and get your Z's. Use as directed. This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production. Welcome to the new Family Feud. What is the top answer to this question? Name an occupation whose people have big egos. If you said the number one answer is actor, you hit the bullseye on the new Family Feud. Introducing the Shannon family, ready for action, playing against the Levy family. On your marks. Let's start the new Family Feud. Here's the star of Family Feud, Ray Cole.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Hello to the Shannon family. Welcome to the Levy family and welcome to you. And to the new Family Feud. We are starting a brand new season. And we're very excited to celebrate. We're going to introduce our brand new bullseye game. I don't know if you know what that means, but it does mean that one of these two families could earn a bank to play for in fast money of up to $20,000. So let's get started by saying hello to our returning champions. Hello there.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you, Joan. Your family is from Southern California.
Yes, we are.
You have $13,770.
Yes, we do.
Tell everybody who you brought.
I brought my husband, Jim.
Howdy, Jim.
Hi. My sister, Kathy. My brother, John. And my baby brother, Rob.
All right. Will you get the chance to play Fast Money, or will it be the Levy family? Wait a minute. Don't be biased as a crowd. Will it be the Levy family? Yeah. Yeah. Jeff, they didn't mean it. Is it Levy or Levy?
Levy.
Levy, all right. Where are you from?
We're Southern California.
And who did you bring?
I brought my lovely wife. I brought my son,
her
Nicholas.
Her name is Heidi.
Heidi, yes. Right. I brought my sister's baby brother, Ned.
Nicholas is your son. Ned is...
My wife's baby brother.
Do you have documentation that you are a family?
Yes, and we're legal.
Too. All right, who else is Ned?
Ned and my daughter, Lissa.
Welcome to the show. Maybe $20,000 will be the bank. Let's start with our new big money bullseye game, where each family will determine the bank that they play for. Each family member will have a chance to add to their bank to see if you can take it as high as possible. We're going to start by putting $5,000 into the Levy Bank, $5,000 into the Shannon Bank. Now, you can add to your bank by giving me the bullseye answer. We ask 100 people this question. The number one answer is the bullseye, and it's worth $1,000. Tell me something that comes with an owner's manual. Joan.
Car.
Is car the bullseye? Bullseye! Shannon's bank goes to $6,000. The second bullseye question is worth $2,000. Name a famous Ronald.
Reagan.
Is Ronald Reagan the bullseye? No. For $2,000, name a famous Ronald.
Ronald McDonald.
Is Ronald McDonald more famous than Ronald Reagan? Is it the bullseye? Bullseye. $7,000 for the Levy's Bank. We now put $3,000 up for grabs. We ask 100 people this. Only one answer, the bullseye. Name a place you've been embarrassed because you didn't have enough money to pay your bill. Kathy.
Grocery store.
Is grocery store the bullseye? No, for $3,000. Give me the bullseye. Place you've been embarrassed because you didn't have enough money to pay the bill.
Restaurant.
Is restaurant the bullseye? Bullseye! $10,000 bank building for the ladies. $4,000 to go to whoever has the bullseye answer to. Name something people do and then say, excuse me. John.
Bump into someone.
$4,000 is bump into them. Bullseye. Something people do and then say, excuse me, Ned.
Effluviation. They fart.
I would say you pretty much hit it on the bullseye there, Ned. Now, let me see. Let me see. Breaking wind for the bullseye. Now, here's an answer that would have been worth $4,000. People do this and then say, I'm sorry. Bullseye? Herb. Wrong area. Here we go. $5,000 now. Who can give me the bullseye answer? We ask 100 people this $5,000 question. Tell me something specific you put on your refrigerator door. We go to Rob.
Magnets.
Is magnets the bullseye? Yes! $5,000 for the Shannons, making an $11,000 bank. The Levies have $10,000. That's the money they'll be playing for in Fast Money if they win the feud. When we return after these messages, a lot more feud and fun coming up. We're back, and it's time to play the feud. Let's go. Heads of the family, join me. The first team to reach 300 points will win the game and play Fast Money for the money they've just built up in their bank in our bullseye game. $11,000 for the Shannons, $10,000 at stake for the Levies, but it could be $20,000, and your family could be standing right here. Would you tell them, Gene Wood, how to get on the feud?
I'll be glad to, Ray. If your family would like to try out for Family Feud and you live in the Los Angeles area, call area code 213-965-9999. If you live in the San Diego area, call area code 619-223-2101. Back to Ray.
Thank you, Gene. Call today. We'd love to have you right here on the feud. You ready, Jeff?
I'm ready.
You ready, Joan?
I'm ready.
I believe you. We asked 100 people this question. The top six answers are on the board. Name something specific that women wear to bed. Joan.
Nightgown.
Show me nightgown. Number one, Jeff, think of the steel. We asked 100 people this, male and female, something specific that women wear to bed, Jim.
Curlers. Either hair.
Did the survey say curlers? Four people agreed. Kathy.
Pajamas.
Yes.
Show me PJs. Oh. There's a hope over there. John.
A man's shirt.
Yeah, yes, that's good.
Do women wear a man's shirt?
Yes. Yes.
How did you know that, John?
I don't know.
Just a lucky guess. Three answers left, and we have baby Rob. You say?
Nada.
Something specific that a woman wears to bed, you say?
Nothing.
Good answer.
Rob, are you married?
No.
Okay.
Just dreams. Just dreams, Ray.
You can tell that Ned is. He said, we can tell. They wear nothing. No! Another lucky guess. All of my women wear nightgowns, or they wear nothing at all. Joan?
Yes?
Keep it rolling.
Okay, I say face cream.
Oh, what a beautiful sight. Face cream.
Yeah!
92 points go to the bank. Jim.
Yeah, Jim.
You're the only one that seems not to know how a woman wears to bed, specifically.
Underwear.
That's it.
Underwear.
Okay.
Come on.
Do you take the bank with underwear?
Oh.
You can steal if Kathy doesn't know. 92 points. You got $11,000 you want to play for. Need an answer.
Socks?
Just socks.
Just socks.
Socks. Good answer.
You have the bank if we see a woman naked in socks. Who's this guy sleeping with? Bigfoot? We're coming right back. The feud's begun. Will they play for $11,000? Will they play for $10,000? Hurry back. We're back. $95 for the champion. 95 points. The leading zero. It's time for another face-off. This point value is doubled. The first family to get to 300 points will play for the banks they've built up. Will it be 11,000 or 10,000? The pressure's on. Heidi takes a deep breath. We ask 100 people this question. Top five answers there. Name something that French people are known for.
Jim?
Romance!
Did romance make the survey?
Good lovers.
70 points go to the bank. Think of that steal over there, Levy family. You've been dogging them, but you haven't quite done anything yourself yet, Kathy.
Good food. Yeah. Food.
Something good that answer. The French people are known for. Good food.
Yes.
Food. Yes.
One, two. John.
At the risk of offending a large group of people, the rudeness.
Now you're meaning that they are.
They have like a. They have
first
like
of
a
all,
rep.
First of all, we're in America.
Yeah.
And you
it's
can.
It's kind of a rep.
You've been there?
No.
But there is a rep that sometimes they are rude.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. John said it. Okay. If you're a French person, rudeness.
That long explanation.
Sorry, John. Rob.
Clothes. Their clothing.
Yes.
French people may be known for their clothing. Fashion. 132 points, a large bank.
I say for kissing on the cheeks. Yeah. Two kisses? Man, even?
I don't quite understand. Could you demonstrate?
Yeah.
Oui,
oui. Yes.
Well, I hope it made the survey. How about the old double kiss?
One more.
Think of a steal. 132 points will be yours, Jim.
Wine.
Yeah. Wine.
If it's there, that makes sense why they kissed twice, because they forgot. Let me see. Wine. Yes. And 68 points. Kathy clean sweep, big lead. Something French people are known for. Take a guess. 3 seconds.
Pastries.
Are you going to take the bank with French pastries?
No.
Levy family, you'll have the lead if you know something that French people are known for.
Hard language.
How old are you, Lisa?
Lisa. I'm 12.
12. So sweet. And lose the attitude. Lisa and Ned?
Gino Lollobrigida.
What? Gino Lollobrigida.
Champagne.
Champagne?
Perfume.
All right. You tell Jeff what will steal this bag.
Perfume.
Got it. Perfume.
He goes with the family and says that 168 plus whatever the value of number five is perfume. With a steal. 176 in points. Come to the leading. It is time for the Shannons to step up for another face-off. We're going to triple the point value, which means either team can win if you take the question all the way out. You seem a bit nervous, Kathy.
I am.
Just relax. Nicholas, you okay?
I'm fine.
That's what scares me. All right. Top five answers are on the board. Besides a teacher, name a job in a high school. Kathy?
Principal.
How about principal? Nicholas, think of a steal. Should have been nervous. Should have been nervous. All right, John.
Counselor.
Yes.
Do you realize that if your family takes this question all the way out, you'll win the game and play for that $11,000?
Yes, I realize that.
Counselor.
Yes. Yes.
Okay, enough money, you can win with a steal. Rob?
Coach.
A coach.
Yes.
Think, Ned.
Thank you now.
besides a teacher?
Secretary.
They do have. We had a great one. They missed Claxton. Let's see a secretary.
No!
First strike.
Janitor.
Yes.
Yeah.
Show me a janitor.
Yes.
Number two, under the principal, is the janitor. Now, Kathy, a little bit of pressure on you, but it's exciting. 270 points there. You give me number five. You're playing for $11,000. A job in a high school.
The nurse?
Is it?
Nurse.
For the game, a nurse.
Oh.
Think of the steal. Come on, John. They're going to steal if you don't know.
Come on. Come on, John.
3 seconds. For the game. Don't say anything. If you don't know, they've won.
Librarian.
Librarian. You don't have to have anything.
Grounds taker.
Librarian. If librarian is there, you have won this game on a steal, and you're playing for 10 grand. If not Shannon's,
librarian.
You're playing fast money for $11,000.
Librarian.
Is it librarian? Living family has stolen the game. I have to say goodbye to our great champions. Joan.
Thank you.
$13,770 yours. You've been very special. Stay here, you playboy. Don't go away. I need two players right now for fast money. $10,000 could be given away right after these messages. Don't go away. We are back with the Levy family, our new champion set to play fast money for $10,000. Ned, I wish you much luck. You built this bank through a bullseye round. We put 15 seconds on the clock. You seem confident. There you go. Straight ahead, we ask 100 people, name a kind of nut that you eat.
Peanut.
The age, that's the prime of life.
35.
Any rank in a police department.
Lieutenant.
A kind of conductor.
Train.
A type of natural disaster.
Brush fire.
Okay, turn around. That's five. Ned, you gave five. Look right there. Stay close. I know this is a little... It gets nervous out here, doesn't it?
Oh, no.
You play at home, it's very easy, isn't it? You don't play at home? You don't play here either, as far as I can tell. So, here you go. Name a kind... Oh, you want me to go ahead and get on with it? Name a kind of nut that you eat, you said? A peanut. The survey said... All right,
yes, 42, okay.
42, the age, that's the prime of life, you said. The age of 35, what did the survey say? 15.
Okay.
Now you like me, Ned.
How is
this? Rank in the police department. Ooh, rank in the police department, you said. Lieutenant, survey said. 12, okay, you're inching up. A kind of conductor, you went with. Train conductor, survey said. 48, you are over 100. Ned, you're the only guy I know that has said two cuss words on the same show. A type of natural disaster, you said the popular. Brush fire, survey said. Zero, but you know what? We don't care because you went over 100. That's your half.
Yeah,
back with
worked.
Your family.
Good job.
Heidi? Heidi, you look straight ahead and let go, Heidi. Thank you, Heidi. Whew, Larry Parker got me $2.1 million. You broke my hand. We will now reveal the answers your partner gave. We give you 20 seconds, but since it's a little more difficult, you might give the same answer. You'll hear this sound if you do. That means you duplicated one of his answers, and I'll say try again. Bring it home. $10,000. We ask 100 people. Name a kind of nut that you eat.
Cashew.
The age, that's the prime of life.
35.
Try again.
32.
Any rank in a police department.
A captain.
A kind of conductor.
A train conductor.
Try again.
A bus conductor.
A type of natural disaster.
A flood.
All right, turn around. Very good job. Is it enough to get you the $10,000? Name a kind of nut that you eat. Oh, you're so nervous. You said? Cashew nut. The survey said? 18 people. You calming down now?
Yeah, I'm fine.
The number one nut was given by Ned. Look at it. Yes, I'm proving once again you are what you eat. Peanut, the number one. I love you, Ned.
Your top's on my list too, pal.
The age, that's the prime of life. You said my age? 32.
Survey said?
0. 40. 40, the number one answer in our survey.
I should know that because I'm going to be 40 on my next birthday.
Happy birthday. A rank in any police department, you said? A captain. Survey said? 30. Sergeant was the number one answer. You are now 2 questions away from the $10,000, a kind of conductor. You tried to say train. Instead, you said a bus conductor. I haven't seen one in a while. Survey said 0.
It's okay.
It is okay. Train was the number one answer. It comes down to this. Let me have your hand for $10,000. Type of natural disaster, you said? A flood. Did 35 people say flood for $10,000? What did our survey say? Earthquake was number one and would have gotten you the $10,000. $5 the point. $915. Come out here and hug her, Ned. You did well. Come on out here. We're coming right back. Our new champions will be here. I think brush fire took them down. Don't go away. For the feud, I'm Ray Combs. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Some of our departing contestants will receive television, is all kinds of basic sweats and t-shirts, Toltecs, a new way of looking at clothes, everything you need to make Chinese meals at home from Joyce Chen products, including the famous Peking pan, Joyce Chen sauces, and Helen Chen's recipe book. Dentuary. Dentugel gets dentures twice as clean as soaking tablets. And Dentugel has meaty mouthwash ingredients to leave dentures tasting mini fresh. Hamburger Helper cheeseburger macaroni with real cheddar cheese. Hamburger Helper helps you make a great meal. Jonelle presents salon-style sculptured nails, easy to apply. Just stick it, buff it, gel it, set it. Gel nails from Jonelle. Magnavox CD radio cassette recorder. It's smart, very smart. Its dynamic bass boost gives it outstanding CD sound performance, furnished by Magnavox. This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production. This program has been edited for broadcast.